Welcome to Woodbridge Channel's coverage of high school sports. We are on the ice rink at the Woodbridge Community Center for a game between visiting Manalapan and host Woodbridge Colonia Kennedy combined township team. I'm John McCormick, your full-time mayor and part-time wannabe sports announcer, and I am joined by the incomparable Abby Karras, who is aspiring to be a sportscaster, and who used to play hockey for this team. So, Abs, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So, Woodbridge comes in at 13-0-1. Manalapan, a pretty good team at 11-3-2. So, this is going to be like what has not happened a lot lately for this team, which is in a good game. Because they've been spanking some teams, right?
Yes, yeah. A lot of mercies.
A lot of mercy rules?
Yeah.
And that's what, 10 goals?
Yes, 10 goals as long as you've completed two periods of
play. Okay. So tell me, what's going on lately with the team? We've not called a game since toward the beginning.
Yeah, well, they're still undefeated. They have one tie against Middletown North, but that's about it. Besides that, they're doing pretty well still. So.
Now, I thought it was weird because I read the Star Ledger rankings, and they were listed as number 11 in the state, but it had them down at 13-0-1.
Yeah.
But then in the text, it said they lost two games to higher-seeded teams. Higher ranked teams, but yet they had it in the paper 13-0-1, so you can't lose two games if you have an O there.
Yeah, that's strange. And I mean, I guess they're ranking 11 because I know I've seen those rankings and there are teams above them that have lost games, but I think it's only because they're playing like harder competition.
Right.
So.
That's good. You got that. You're good.
Thank you. Face off at center ice here.
On the ice now, we didn't give you your starters, and this is going to be difficult because we have this roster not in number order. So you got to go search. 89 is Aiden McCarthy. Number 5, there is no number 5. Number 13 is Braden Rafferty. Almost a shot there. 74 is Raymond Obolsky. 71 is Ryan Zweibel. And 89 is, I said Aiden McCarthy. And number 9 is Patrick Rennie. The starters were Brendan Errol, Dylan Godsell, Ryan Luco, Hubert Polchlopik, and Christopher Wallace. Nice stick move there by Luco. Here he goes. Almost
gets past Manalapan.
Oh, my. What a good play by Luco.
Good shot on that.
Yeah.
Sweeps keeps it in.
Sweeps, look at you.
Nice save by the goalie of Manalapan.
Yeah, you can use your nicknames if you want. It's not a problem.
Okay, sounds good.
Back in for now comes Braden. Is that Irel? Errol?
Errol?
A-I-R-E-L?
Yeah, Errol. That sounds about right.
I haven't seen that name before.
Yeah, he's new. I think he transferred from STA, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Aw, good cross-ice pass to Dylan.
Well, does STA even have a hockey team?
No, I don't think they do.
I wonder why he waited so long to transfer. I mean, you know what? He probably did, but had to sit out a couple games maybe.
Yeah.
Here comes Manalapan, and they're a pretty big team compared to, well, maybe equal to us. They're not bigger than us, but they are a big team.
Yeah. Good shot blocked by there by Woodbridge. Manalapan gets it at center ice. Stuck in the skates of Hubert.
Hunter Galgani is the goalie for Woodbridge.
Offsides on Woodbridge. Going to be a face-off right outside the blue line. Does it say who the Manalapan goalie is on here?
No, it does not. It doesn't have really positions. Number 33, though. Jared Sturm? No, he's only got one game played. Can't be him. Doesn't that say 33? It's far away.
Yeah, it does.
You got better eyes than me, let me tell you.
I have contacts in. Puck is shot all the way down the ice. It's going to be a nice thing on Manalapan.
I wouldn't imagine they'd go into the game with a guy who's only got one game.
Yeah. Well, I know they played their first playoff game within their conference yesterday, so maybe they're resting their starting goalie potentially.
Could be. Well, Sturm has one assist, so he's probably not a goalie. Well, they could be, I guess. A goalie can get an assist.
Yeah.
Four shots on goal for Woodbridge. Nothing yet for Manalapan.
Brandon Rafferty wins the faceoff, but it leaves the zone. Ryan Douglas with the puck now. Gets around one Manalapan defender in the second. Goes wide outside. Takes it around the net to Zweebs. Shoots it. Good shot on net with a rebound, but Manalapan clears.
You're getting the hang of this. Did you do another game besides the first one with me?
No, I didn't. Big hit by Ryan Zwiebel there, but it's going to be a penalty.
Thought he'd have to do that.
Yeah. Manalapan has it behind the net. Cross ice pass.
And this is the delayed penalty, so they pulled the goalie.
Yeah, so they had six people on the ice.
So explain, I know how that works, but explain it for the crowd.
So
you're smarter than me in hockey.
So basically when a penalty is called, the team that it's called on, the ref won't blow the whistle until that team touches the puck. So the team without the penalty basically will pull their goalie and they can send an extra player on the ice for that goalie. So you're basically playing 6-on-5 until the team either touches the puck or you score a goal.
And you know that they can't score a goal because to score a goal they have to touch the puck, and they can't touch the puck unless, and that will make the play over. So they don't need the goalie.
I have seen, though, where they score own goals on themselves because they, like, pass it backwards and expect a player to be there and it just...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, so there is some danger in pulling a goalie.
Yeah. It's very rare, but you see, like, NHL
Could
clips.
Happen.
Yeah.
Penalty. Oh. They had a perfect shot if he could have controlled that. That was an open net.
Yeah, if you one-timed that there, I probably would have scored.
Oh,
Luco gets around one.
Almost. Let's go,
he
Luco.
Still has it. Oh, he gets caught up by a Manalapan defender. Manalapan has it behind their own net.
So we have Arell, we have Luco, we have Dylan Gotzel, and this
Schmelzer gets around one Woodbridge
Wallace,
defender.
Wallace. I keep saying Wallace. It's Wallace.
Arell clears. Luco has it center ice to Dylan Gotzel. Dylan gets around one defender. Shot on net. Good save by the Manalapan goalie.
Get that out of there. Get it out of there. That's it. That's, oh, not that way.
Offsides on Manalapan. Faceoff is going to be right outside the blue line. Woodbridge's blue line.
So we've wiped out a little over half the penalty with no damage.
Shot 6-1 in favor of Woodbridge.
Same players on the ice now. They're on for quite a bit of this penalty kill.
Or they changed Luco and Rafferty.
Did?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There's Hubert.
And Hubert.
Oh, they
and
did
Dylan.
Change. All right. Yeah.
Not sure if the defense changed, though. I think same defense. Oh, actually, no, because Arrow was on the ice before.
They're all new.
Yeah. Full change.
I'm just so used to seeing all these numbers. 22 seconds left now.
Doing a good job holding it in the Manalapan zone, but Manalapan is breaking out. Behind Woodbridge's own net.
10 seconds now in the penalty. Little more, I'd say that should do it. That should do the penalty kill. There it go. Oh, here we go!
Rafferty on a breakaway.
Get him, get him, get him!
Good save by
good
the Manalapan
save.
Goalie. That
wow.
was a beautiful pass
that
by
was amazing.
Wallace, I think it was by.
That could have been a heck of a shorthanded goal.
Yeah. But good thing is the Woodbridge penalty is over, so we're back to 5-on-5 hockey.
Okay. Irel is on the ice right now with Ryan Zweibel. Let's see, 93 is Dylan Gotzel.
Hubert Pochlepek and Luco.
Luco. Those guys have an insane number of goals, don't they?
Yeah. I think, Luco and Hubert are both up there in most points this season, like, out of all of Jersey.
Really?
Which is really impressive. Yeah, both of them. To have both of them up there is really, really impressive.
Now, which one's the senior and which one's the junior?
Hubert with the puck right now is the senior, and then Luco, number 88, is the junior. Hubert takes it around the net. Good pass to Dylan.
Oh!
Did that get deflected off of a Manalapan defenseman skate, I think?
It could
have. Good keep by Dylan there, but Manalapan picks it back up.
Sure, are we live, Facebook live? We are, cool. Oh, we're YouTube live too.
Oh, wow.
Man, you're a celebrity, Abby.
Wallace picks up the puck. Dumps it into the Manalapan zone. Good keep by Hubert there. Oh, that's
oh,
a
hook.
Oh, that's
a penalty.
That's a hook on number
yep.
13 on Manalapan. There you go. Now you see Hunter.
Now there goes our goalie. Goes yeah. off.
But since Manalapan touched the puck, now it's going to be a stoppage of play.
So that's the goalie's got to be aware of that, right?
Yeah.
So because you can't always communicate with the bench. You got to know yourself if you're the goalie to jump off, right?
Yeah, for sure. And you can tell when the ref raises his hand. You just have to make sure that you're not wrong and it's not like a potential offsides, or it could even be a penalty on your team, because then if you go off, then you're
really
a little screwed.
Trouble.
Yeah. Power play unit right now, I think, is...
It's Luko, it's Polchilpek.
Aiden, oh no, who's 89?
It's Wallace.
Aiden McCarthy and Wallace. So they set up a little strange on the power play because Luko and Hubert, who are usually forwards, are line up in the faceoff as more of a defensive position.
Now, why do you think that is?
I think it's so they can distribute the puck better, because so that way if someone passes it back to them at the points, they can take it and skate it in. It's just so they're not limited to the smaller areas that are more forward and closer to the net.
I think you got this game. I would not have known that. I would not have recognized that.
And a lot of different teams have different setups for their power play.
Do you ever watch film of the team you're about to play?
I personally haven't, also because I'm a goalie, so like my really only job was to just stop the puck. But I know most teams definitely do like watch film and kind of see how other
tendencies.
Teams play. Yeah. Oh, big hit by Luko there.
So even you as a goalie, you wouldn't want to see how guys approach on a breakaway or a two-on-one or.
I mean, I feel like that's also very situational. Watching film, I feel like I also don't want to assume when, like, say I was out on the ice, I don't want to assume they're going to do one thing. So I kind of just, like, take it with the...
All right. Yeah. That makes sense.
There is a lot of different traits. Oh, good stop by the goalie there on Hubert.
The penalty's over now, so we're back to even strength. And
oh,
the lines
there's still
will change.
13 seconds left.
Oh, I'm looking at the wrong side. My bad. I was looking at the left. That was our penalty. So now we've got
Braden Rafferty.
Tyrell Wallace. Let's see, you guys turn around. We've got Obolsky.
Pat Rennie and Braden Rafferty.
Okay.
Face off in the Manalapan zone. Errol keeps it in. Deep in the Manalapan corner. Errol with the puck. And see, Hunter's tapping a stick to let his team know that
the
penalty's over.
Oh,
yeah.
good.
That way his defense knows that there's going to be an extra person. Just like this with a breakaway. And a goal by Manalapan, number 9, I believe. Josh Kushnir.
Now, that is something I'm not used to seeing. I think it's the first time that I've actually heard of even Woodbridge being down in the game. They're usually up 4-0 by this time.
Yeah, especially since the shots are so uneven.
Right.
10 shots to 2.
2 shots, 1 goal.
Yep.
Or would they have put that shot up already? They probably did, right?
I think they would have.
I mean, they know it's a shot. There's no debate.
Yeah. That's a tough one, too, because there's really nothing Hunter could have done about that one. But.
Uh-oh.
Another bad play here. Cross-ice pass right into the slot. Good block by Aiden McCarthy. Another shot. Another block by Aiden. He dumps it all the way down, but Pat's on the puck. He beats the Manalapan defender. Good shot in net, but good save by the Manalapan goalie. It's going to be a face-off in the Manalapan zone. puck goes out of play. The faceoff's going to be right outside the Woodbridge zone.
So how's school going overall?
We just started second semester, so my classes are all brand new. But I did well in my first semester classes and on all my finals, which is good. I'm just glad finals are over, honestly.
Yeah, a lot of stress.
Yeah. And I have gym this semester, so
that's
I have a little break.
That's a tough course, huh?
Yeah.
Come on. The only thing easier is lunch.
But all my other courses are kind of hard, so... But at least I have the gym break.
Are you taking a particular field of study, or just all general courses?
Well...
Any concentration?
Not really. I did switch one of my classes to AP macroeconomics because I want to go into business. Oh, I want to go to business school.
All right.
Almost a goal there by Woodbridge, but I'm just taking a lot of APs right now, so it's a little stressful.
How do you have time to do hockey?
Well, I don't.
Oh, but this is a passion, right?
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to follow your passion.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Hunter was there, though. Missed wide.
Still 13-2 in shots. This is ridiculous.
Manalapan walks out of the corner with it, takes a deflection, but goes wide.
When's the last time we had 13 shots and no goals?
A long time, honestly.
What year, maybe?
Oh, nice turn there by Brendan. Skates through the middle of the ice. Manalapan defenders on him, and he loses the puck. Woodbridge has it behind their own net, and they dump it up the boards to center ice. Manalapan dumps it in again, and Chris Wallace picks it up behind his own net.
It's a pretty intense game. These guys are playing hard, both sides.
Yeah, it's a good game so far, for sure. Manalapan has it in the Woodbridge corner, but Christopher Wallace picks it up. All the way down the ice. No icing, though. Manalapan dumps it again to center ice. And then back down into the Woodbridge zone.
Seems like they're playing a lot in our end.
Yeah.
Even though we're way up on the shots, it seems like a lot of action.
I feel like a lot of their shots are either missing the net or getting blocked. Oh, here we go. Ryan Douglas, two on one with Braden
Rafferty.
Good pass. Oh, and Braden just misses the net.
Yeah, just missed.
Great pass there by Ryan Douglas, though. Pat almost had an opportunity there, too, but it got intercepted. And Dougie dumps it all the way down into the Manalapan zone.
Look, go back on the ice now.
Come on, get on that guy.
Good save there by Hunter. Good block there by Ryan Zweibel. Oh, no.
Ah, darn. Too much time with the puck in front of us.
Yep, and Manalapan's up 2-0.
They seem like too good a team to let that happen.
Shots are still very one-sided.
I know, four shots, two goals.
The defense probably should have cleared that puck there. They had a good block at first, but.
Do we have any idea when the county tournament is?
Should be soon.
Should be soon is right.
Yeah.
Basketball started.
Oh, did it really?
Yeah.
Have you announced any basketball games?
Yeah, I've done a bunch. You know, and it's my fault. I should have called you for the girls' game we did.
Oh.
That's my bad. I said I would.
Was it Colonia? Or what school?
We called Colonia Woodbridge, and we called Kennedy Woodbridge. And we called Kennedy. I'm trying to think. I've done 3 girls' games and 1 boys' game.
Gotcha.
But we should have Woodbridge girls next week play Edison, but it's away. Colonia girls will have a home game, so when we do that, I'll let you know.
Okay. I'm not as knowledgeable with basketball, I'm not going to lie. Oh, good shot by Luca there, but also a good save by the Manalapan.
Well, you can just kind of hang out.
Yeah, see how it works.
You know, do a little studying on the players maybe.
Gotcha.
Colony girls have a good team. They got two incredibly good players.
Yeah.
And Taylor Durkak and Madison Chiara. Madison just took the lead in career girls scoring for Colony.
Oh, wow.
With a, I forget the number. She already had 1,000, but yeah. She now has the career lead.
Impressive. Dylan Gotzel has it in his own zone. Passes to Aiden McCarthy, and here Luco loses the puck. Manalapan through the middle of the ice, enters the Woodbridge zone, dumps it behind the net.
Under 30 seconds to go now.
Oh,
boy, that was dangerous.
Number 9 just misses the net for Manalapan. Got to get the puck out here for Woodbridge. Huber has the puck. He passes off to Luco. He has two defenders to beat. He can't beat number 40, Yakub.
Manalapan's not letting us get behind them, that's for sure.
Yeah, their defense is very strong. Hubert almost went to behind Manalapan's net there. Good keep by Aiden. Just misses the net. Shots are still so uneven.
Yeah, really. So anyway, it is now the end of the first period. Manalapan 2, Woodbridge Township 0. Stay with us, folks. We will be back. No, we're live on Facebook. Might as well stay here. Let's talk about the weather. How do you like the weather?
It's a little up and down, I'm not going to lie. It was freezing this weekend. And
yeah, but that's okay. You don't plow freezing.
True. But, like, it messes. I feel like it messes with, like,
the birds and the flowers get all messed up.
Oh. I was talking about, like, health. I feel like a lot of people are sick.
Oh, that's the truth. Because, literally, I mean, when you're in 55 degrees, the next day you're in 15 degrees.
Yeah. I was visiting colleges this weekend in Pittsburgh, and it was freezing.
What
was
colleges?
Like 10 degrees. University of Pittsburgh and Carnegie Mellon.
You didn't look at Duquesne?
We were going to, but it ended up being too cold, and we just didn't.
That's where my daughter went.
Oh, really?
Yeah, good school. Very good school.
Yeah. And we were
They're rated high for business.
Oh, are they really?
At least they were when she went, which was a while ago, 14 years ago. She's 32.
I'm sure they're still up there. I guess it 33 is Jared Sturm.
Must be, yeah. So, when you say business, have you taken any business courses in Kennedy yet?
Just macroeconomics, or I'm taking that now. I also took, sports marketing and, I think it was just regular marketing. It was, like, in the same course my freshman year, but since then I haven't. So I think my senior year I'm going to pick up a lot more business courses.
Are you accounting number oriented at all? Good with math?
I think so, but I mean, I think I'm going to take statistics next year, too.
That's a good one.
Yeah, so that'll definitely help.
That'll give you a feel if you can handle the math.
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you, accounting is a wonderful career.
Yeah.
I've been an accountant. My daughter's an accountant. She works for one of the big four CPA firms, and she's doing very, very well. I think accounting is a wonderful major.
Well, like, statistics math is very different than, like, calculus,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes, very different. Yeah. Calculus is more math. Well, no, not more math. It's more, how do I describe it?
Well, I guess statistics is more numbers.
Yeah, more numbers.
Yeah. Because I
like calculus. I took it in college. I loved it.
Yeah, I'm doing, like, pretty decent. I'm taking calc right now, and I'm doing pretty decent in it. But statistics is a whole different ball game, I feel like.
It is. Yeah. I love both. I should have been, I was almost going to be a math major.
Really?
Yeah, it was because I'm a numbers freak.
Yeah.
I do Sudokus, you know, all day. Ken-Kens all day. Not all day.
So how did you feel about English then?
Didn't like it.
I feel like there's you either really like math and you don't like English.
Yeah, exactly.
Or you really
that's
like
me.
English and you don't
My
like
freshman
math.
Year in college, I got straight A's and a C in English comp the first semester. And the second semester, I got straight A's and a C in English comp again. I just wasn't oriented toward that. But then I started doing a lot of writing, and now I feel like, you know, writing is what everybody needs to do in your career.
Yeah.
No matter what job you have to write.
Yeah,
I write all the time.
Writing is definitely, like, my English classes, I definitely know I'm going to use the stuff I'm learning in my future, whereas calculus, I don't know how much I'm going to...
No, you're not.
Yeah. Like, no stats, on the other hand, if I want to go into accounting or anything, I will use that, but...
No one's going to say to you, hey, you see that salt dome over there? I wonder how many grains of salt it holds. But if you had calculus, you'd know that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, you have geometry, you might know that, too.
Or, like, integrals and... what are the other ones?
I liked physics, too, because it had a lot of math. I hated chemistry.
Oh, you liked physics?
Oh, I do. I love physics. I took 2 semesters in college. I hated biology.
Well, that's if you want to become a doctor.
I just couldn't stand it. Chemistry was not my favorite either, but love physics, hate biology. Chemistry is eh.
Fair. I feel like I'm the same way. I haven't taken physics, though, so.
If you don't have to, don't. Why mess up your cum?
True. And I feel like it'd just be another math course, so I don't know if I'd want to add that on.
But at some point, take an accounting course just to see.
Yeah.
They offer it in Kennedy?
I think so. They offer so many courses at Kennedy. We got the course sheet because we're starting scheduling for next year.
Oh, really?
And it's... Like, there are so many classes on them, so.
That's good. Says a lot about our school system.
Yeah, it does.
But my advice to anybody thinking about a business or economics is to take an introductory accounting class.
Yeah.
And you might just fall in love with it. And also the opposite. If you could be there a week and you'll know you're not going to be an accountant. And I've talked to kids about that, you know, my friends' kids. Mm-hmm. And I say in the first week you'll know if you got this. And seriously, the guys that got it graduated with accounting, and I know one friend whose kid didn't get it and didn't last the semester.
Yeah.
You can tell right away.
Yeah. Macro right now, I'm actually really enjoying it, and I get the concept, so hopefully it stays like that.
Yeah, macro's fun.
Yeah.
And plus, you can read the paper a lot and see what's going on in the country, you know, deficit-wise and all that, and be relevant.
Yeah.
All right, folks, we're back now for the start of the second period. John McCormick, Abby Karras, here at the Woodbridge Community Center for a hockey game, or is it a hockey match? It's a hockey game.
Hockey game, I'd
say. Between Woodbridge and Manalapan. Manalapan's up 2-0. They came in with an 11-3-2 record. Woodbridge countered with a 13-0-1 record. I didn't see what Manalapan, if they were rated in the top 20 in the state. Woodbridge with number 11. And they called a try-op team. Not sure what the op stands for. Get it in. Oh, get it in. There's a lot of try-op teams, actually.
Yeah.
Edison, Stevens, and Metuchen is one. And East Brunswick, maybe Spotswood and somebody else is another try-op team.
East Brunswick, Spotswood, and South River.
Okay.
Yeah. And then I think North and South Brunswick are...
They're combined?
Yeah.
That's the right thing to do.
Yeah, especially when you don't have enough players to field
right.
the team.
This baffles me, though, Abs, because... In 2007, when this started, we had 3 teams with 20 kids in each team.
Yeah. I still look at that, and I'm like, I don't know how JFK had that enough players to field a full team.
I know.
Like,
they did,
though. That's crazy to me. Shot by number 19 on Manalapan, but it gets deflected by the Woodbridge defender.
And they had one of the best players ever to play at Woodbridge High School, which I think is Justin Zizel.
Oh. Did he end up going D1 or?
I don't remember. And Danny Swansboro was one of the other stars that year. Those 2 guys were the 2 best players for the beginning of Woodbridge Township hockey.
Do you think Hubert and Luco have a chance?
I think they are the equivalents.
Okay.
They are absolutely the equivalents, if not better.
Were those 2 guys playing at the same time? Like, were they
different teams? Swansboro was Woodbridge, and Zizel was Kennedy.
Just imagine if they were like on a team like it is now.
Well, Zizel was a defender, and he was an amazing defender.
Gotcha.
Swansboro was a scoring machine, like Luco and Hubert.
Hubert gets kicked out of the. Oh, never mind. He's still in. So Woodbridge has a penalty. I think
it
was
156 to
Brendan.
Go.
Yeah, he just got a great save by Hunter
there.
Yeah,
that was almost a shorthanded goal they gave up.
Yeah. Or no, we have the penalty. It's a penalty on us.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. So Manalapan's on the power play. I think it was a tripping call on Brendan Arrow.
Well, we cannot afford to go down 3-0 to this team. This team is too good. Do parents know that no one can hear them on the ice, or can you hear them on the ice?
Personally, I couldn't, but I mean, they have to have some idea, right? Good save by Hunter there, keeping Woodbridge in the game here. Shots are closing the gap, 16-10 now.
Good point.
Yeah. Still 1:30 left in the Woodbridge penalty, though. Another good save by Hunter. Rebound's kicked right out, but he misses the net.
They're going to be caught up in shots pretty soon.
Yeah. Hubert gets the puck all the way down the ice. That's really what you want to do on a penalty kill. Just waste as much time as possible. Manalapan passes the puck to Josh Kushner. He has it in the corner. Passes it behind the net. Ooh, shot by number 8 on Manalapan, hits the post. Manalapan still has the puck. Oh, and another goal by Manalapan, number 8, Mike Schmelzer. 3-0 now. Woodbridge really can't afford to take any more penalties.
No, that's the second shorthanded, right?
I mean, second power play goal,
I should have said.
Yeah.
That was a good goal by Manalapan. That was not much. You couldn't fault Woodbridge much for that. I didn't think, but.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Number 27, shot blocked by Christopher Wallace. They just have to not run around and kind of hold their positions. Ooh, gets deflected there.
So they're going to be the number 1 seed in the county tournament.
They should be, yes.
And what do you have? Oldbridge, Monroe, St. Joe's. Who else? The Brunswick team, the Edison team. In the
playoffs? Or
yeah.
Oh, another goal by Manalapan. Someone lost their man in front of the net. I think it was 24. 24, Joe Lombardo. Oh, I don't think it was 20. I think it was, no, sorry, 26, Alfred Pacino.
I don't think yelling at your team's a good idea right now when they're down, right? I mean, you need to pick them up. You don't need to put them down. They feel bad enough.
Ryan Tweeble collects the puck behind the net.
So anyway, it'll be Woodbridge, Oldbridge, St. Joe's, Monroe are the teams that are good.
Yeah.
The East Brunswick tri-op, the Edison tri-op, and the North-South Brunswick tri-op, right?
Yeah.
So there's 7 teams, and it's
I believe so.
Yeah, I can't think of anybody else.
Braden Rafferty has the puck. Shot on net. Good save by the Manalapan goalie. Manalapan takes it down the ice, dumps it into the corner, goes around the net. Ryan Dweeble picks it up, plays it along the boards. Manalapan intercepts the pass in the middle of the ice, offsides. Offsides on Woodbridge. They had a good opportunity there too. Is it only top 4 team makes the...
I don't know. I
think it might be.
I remember when there were 6.
Oh, actually, you're right. I think it is 6.
Yeah, I remember there were 6 and 3 played 6 and 4 played 5 and then the winners, I don't know. But
so does that mean only one team doesn't make the playoffs?
I don't know.
Playoffs?
I don't know if you've ever had... I think that when I remember there being 6, we only had 6.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to think of who we could have picked up. Oh, you know, we picked up East Brunswick. That's who we picked up. So I don't know what they'll do.
Ooh.
They could give number 1 a bye, 2 play 7, 3-6, and then 4-5.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Good chip. Manalapan has a 2-on run. Gets caught up in his skates. Manalapan dumps the puck all the way into Woodbridge's zone. Luca has it around the net. He loses the puck, though, in his own zone.
Nice move.
Number 9 has it now. Good defending there by Wallace.
Looked like he was playing basketball, boxing the guy out.
They're just all over Woodbridge.
They're alive.
Yeah.
I mean, for 14-2 shots on goal.
Yeah. I know they also had a big win last night, so they're probably still fired up from that. Oh, ref. Should have been off sides there. Not sure. No, there we go.
One of the few times you actually see the puck hit the refs. They do such a remarkable job of staying out of the play.
Penalty on Manalapan. Number 8, Mike Schmelzer. All right, let's see if Woodbridge can do something with this power play then.
I'd venture to say if we don't, we're in real trouble.
Oh, for sure, yeah. Face-off in Manalapan zone. Christopher Wallace taking the face-off. You see Hubert and Ryan Luco in the defensive position almost. Luco with the puck all the way back in his zone. Hubert with the puck now, passes it over to Luco. Luco gets around one Manalapan defender. Other one falls, but a good defensive play. Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Good defense there by Chris Wallace. They just need to get it in the Manalapan zone and keep it there. Oh, God. Christopher Wallace around the net. Passes the puck off to Dylan Godsell. To Hubert Pochelpack. To Luco, and he misses the net wide. Goal!
Score!
Dylan Godsell. At least they're back in the game a little bit here.
Almost.
Almost. Get the momentum going, hopefully. Hopefully this is good news for Woodbridge.
Let's see if it'll spark them and get them on a little run here. Back to even strength.
Manalapan takes it into the Woodbridge zone. Passes it across the ice. Uh-oh. Good save by Hunter there. Pat Rennie clears the puck. Out to Rayabolski. He has Braden Rafferty with them. Passes off to Braden, but it goes right through his legs.
It doesn't feel like Hunter's playing a four-goal game at all.
Oh, no. Hunter's playing amazing. He can't really do much when, I feel like a lot of them are either really close range shots or rebounds that aren't being cleared. Manalapan has it at center ice. Good defense by Aiden McCarthy. Battling in the corner against two Manalapan players. Brandon Rafferty's there to help him though. Oh, Ryan Zwiebel picks up the puck. Out to center ice, Pat Rennie has it. It's gonna be a 3-on-2. He has Braden Rafferty and Rayabolski. Good defense by Manalapan. Ooh. Daniel Yakub has the puck for Manalapan. Skates all the way through center ice. Good defense by Ryan Zwiebel there. Big hit. Out to the center, but whoever was marking that play in the middle. Luco flips it out to Hubert. That should be interference or something there. Luco picks up the puck behind the net, passes it to Hubert.
I couldn't see it. You could see better than me. And the fans all put their hands up.
Yeah, like, I had to lean over.
Wonder where the call is.
It was in the corner, or near corner.
But, I mean, everybody thought it was
hand
a
pass. Yeah, it definitely looked like a penalty, but you never know with the refs.
One job I would never want in my life is a referee or umpire.
Yeah.
But I did it when I was a kid, but I...
Did you really? For what sport?
Baseball.
There's really no point in arguing with them because they're not going to change their call either way. Face off back in the Woodbridge zone. I think it was a hand pass. Shot on net. Good hold by Hunter there, making sure there's no rebound. Gonna be a face off to the right of Hunter. Uh-oh. Is that a save? Great save by Hunter there.
Yeah, he's on fire.
Wow. That was a beautiful save. I think also a big point is just to win face-offs because we're losing a lot of face-offs, especially in our zone, and it's giving them possession of the puck, and we just can't get it out.
I'd love to have, like, in-game stats. That'd be great. If
you yeah.
Football, like, even full penny sport. But it's impossible when there's two people.
Luca with the puck now. Dumps it. Manalapan takes it into the Woodbridge zone. Tries to pass to the middle, but gets intercepted by, I think, Dylan. Hubert has it behind his own net. Plays it to Wallace. Then passes to Dylan, who misses the pass. Goes all the way deep into the Manalapan zone, or around the net. Manalapan breaks it out. Number 9 coming down the wing. Luco has the puck now. Skates it up the ice. Passes to Dylan Gotzel. Back to Luco. Gets caught in skates. Great save by the goalie there.
I thought we had that one.
Yeah. Aw. Gotta watch the great cross ice pass there by Manalapan. What a save. I don't know if that was by Hubert or Hunter. Great defensive play there, though. Gotta get the puck out of the net, out of the zone. Wally has the puck now. Dumps it all the way down the ice to Hubert, who's there.
A little too far.
No icing, though. Pass. Goal by Hubert! From the weirdest angle.
Yep.
From
behind
the goalie.
Went off the back of the goalie. Yep. Went off his skate or his pad in the back.
Yeah. He was looking for Luco, who was in front of the net, but the goalie ended up cheating a little bit from his post, and it ended up going right through his legs and hitting his back skate and going into the net. Nice goal by Hubert there.
We'll take it.
Even if it was unintentional. 14 now?
He planned on doing that.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
All right, so 4-2, we're down. But we scored 2 in a row.
Icing on Manalapan, all the way back into their zone.
Coming, if we could ever come back from the 4-goal deficit to win this game, that would be remarkable.
There's still a lot of time left, too, so hopefully we can pull this one out.
Yeah, game's a little over halfway over.
Not sure what happened over there, but good interception by Pat there. Dougie with the puck, but loses it at center ice. Manalapan has it and skates it up. Big hit there by Dougie. Pat flicks it into the Manalapan zone. Manalapan goalie plays it into the corner. And Manalapan flips it all the way down into the Woodbridge zone. Hunter's going to play that puck to Ryan Zwiebel. Uh-oh. Here we go. Aiden McCarthy comes out with it. 3-2. Passes it to the center. Pat was there, too. The puck was just bouncing. Good back check there by Aiden.
Hit the skate of the Manalapan player.
Yeah, Braden's pass. Ryan Zwiebel behind the net with the puck. Big hit there. Another big hit by Ryan. Aiden McCarthy with the behind the net. Flings it up the boards. Woodbridge gets it out. Oh, gets caught in Dougie's skate. But all the way down into the Woodbridge zone. They're going to get a change, at least some of the Woodbridge players. All the way down. It's going to be an icing on Woodbridge. Shots are definitely more even now.
Yes, they are.
Oh, Good move by Hubert.
Do you have any idea if he's got college plans?
I think, I'm not sure hockey-wise if he has any offers or anything like that. I know he's been getting accepted into a lot of the colleges he's applied to.
Oh, yeah, I got to believe he's a college hockey player.
Yeah, he's also very smart.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He's a big kid for, you know, a lot of programs, smaller kids, you know, getting to college and they're overmatched, but Hubert's got the size.
Yeah, he's tall. Manalapan gets it out of their zone. Wallace picks it up. Cross-ice pass to Manalapan. Shot is wide. Toluco going up the boards. He's one-on-one with a Manalapan defender. Gets around one. Loses it in the corner, though. But two-on-one for Manalapan, it looks like. Good save
wide
by
open.
Hunter.
Wow.
Good
oh,
save.
Man. Hunter covered it, left it open. They couldn't capitalize. And then he got back really quick by the time they got the puck to shoot it. Very quick for Hunter.
Feels like there's a lot of odd man rushes for Manalapan, so I'm not sure what's going on with the Woodbridge defense. I think they're just pinching a lot. Face off in the Woodbridge zone. Aiden McCarthy behind the net with it. Dumps it up the boards. Takes a weird bounce. Got to watch the guy in the middle there. Manalapan has it. I think it gets deflected and out of play. Woodbridge's corner. Manalapan has the puck behind Woodbridge's net now. Passes it to the slot. Great save
by
Hunter there.
Wow, I thought that was going to go in for sure.
Me too. Wow, Hunter's really standing on his head back there. He needs a little help from his team.
And now they've taken the lead in shots on goal.
Yep. Oh, good intercept. Goal by Beautiful goal there. Not a great rebound by the Manalapan goalie, and Pat capitalizes. 4-3, they're coming back, they're back in it. I think the first goal was just the momentum they needed.
Yep, yep. Who scored that, number 9?
Yes, number 9, Pat Rennie. Not sure who it was assisted by, either Braden or Rayabolski, I think. Hopefully, too, they'll be able to go into the third period on a high.
I say tie it up before we get to the third. What do you think?
Hopefully. Just under a minute left.
That was some heck of an attempt at a goal by Manalapan. Oh. I swore that was going to be in.
Hunter's really, like, keeping them in this game.
Then we go right down and get our own goal. So what a turn. Could have been 5-2. Now it's 4-3.
And now we have our first line back out on the ice, too. So maybe they can tie things up before the period's over. Hubert's going to take the faceoff. Oh, all the way down into the Woodbridge zone, it looks like. But there's a Manalapan player pressuring pretty hard. No penalty there, which is a little, yeah.
They're relentless. They're tough.
Feels like every time a Woodbridge player gets a pass, there's another Manalapan player on him. Luco almost gets around that player, but back to Brendan. Ooh. Pass gets intercepted to Luco. Takes it wide. Around. Oh!
Oh!
17 seconds left in the second period.
Wow.
Oh, I think Manalapan's stunned.
Yeah, they sure are.
We just got to keep this up.
Four goals in the period, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, here comes Woodbridge again. Over to Godsell in the corner. Shot goes right behind the net. Brendan has it. He has 7 seconds left. Probably going to hold it for... Good way to end the period there, that's for sure.
Wow, they're pumped up now. Too bad this is the Zamboni period. Otherwise, they get right back on the ice and keep that momentum.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll take a break for the Zamboni period. John McCormick, Abby Karras, Woodbridge Community Center. Manalapan 4, Woodbridge Tri-Op 4. We'll be back, folks. Stick around. This is going to be a good ending.
The average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds. Stop the texts. Stop the wrecks. Visit us at stoptextstoprex.org.
And we're back at the Woodbridge Community Center. John McCormick, Abby Karras, Woodbridge Tri-Op Hockey Team 4, Manalapan 4. It was 4-0 Manalapan. Now it's 4-4. Exciting, very exciting second period if you're a Woodbridge fan. Lousy if you're a Manalapan fan. First period was the opposite.
Good save by Hunter there. Good clear, too, of the rebound. Huber passes it to Dylan. Dylan Aluko. Shot on net. Good save. Goal by Dylan Gunson. Way to start the third period.
You aren't kidding. That's only 24 seconds in. Well, you can't see this on TV, folks, but Abby Karras is going wild.
Oh, great goal there.
I was just going to say, so the period between 1 and 2, the time between 1 and 2 is very short. The time between 2 and 3, much longer because they do clear the ice with the Zamboni. So I was going to say, what about the lull, and will it take away the momentum from Woodbridge? But obviously not.
It was a good shot by Luco there to get the rebound, and then Dylan Godsell buried it. Here comes Manalapan, but Wallace intercepts it. To Luco, to Dylan. Back to Luco. Back to Dylan. Gets caught up in a Manalapan skate.
Shoot it!
Luco has it. A little regroup here.
So we all know that Luco and Pulchilpeck are the big scorers. Luco has 40 goals. Hubert Pulchilpeck has 26. But Dylan and Braden Rafferty are tied.
Good play by Hunter
there.
Hunter,
he's down. He's down. Timeout. Uh-oh. That doesn't look good. Let's get the trainer out there. Somebody got to get out there. Here comes the coach. Anyway, did Dylan Godsell and Braden Rafferty have 15 goals each? For assists, it's Hubert with 51, Luco with 31. That means Hubert Pulchilpeck, number 77, came into the game with 77 points. Luco, number 88, wishes he came in with 88 points, but he came in with 71. 29 points for Breeden. I'm sorry, Dylan Godsell, 41 assists, 56 points. Rafferty, 29 points. Obolsky, 24 points. 17 for Patrick Rennie and 14 for Brendan Errol.
Good thing is he's up.
He's up, but he looks like he might be going off the ice.
I don't think so.
No?
No. Way to be, Hunter.
Well, he's kind of leaning over like it's his something around the midsection.
It all happened so fast.
I know. All of a sudden he was down on the ground with his head in the ice.
Yeah, but it was a great play by him to come out and get the puck.
Yeah, he is playing tonight a phenomenal game. Yep, he's staying in. So Hunter Galgani has saved 249 goals out of 267. So you figure that is 25 would be 250. He's got a pretty high...
Pretty good save percentage.
Save percentage, well into the high 90s. Noah Gibb, the backup goalie, has 60, 53 saves and 60 chances.
Dylan's going to pick up the puck there in Manalapan zone. Good defense by the Manalapan defender. Deep into the Manalapan zone again. Flings it all the way down nice into the Manalapan bench. Should be a face-off in the Manalapan zone. Pat Rennie, Braden Rafferty, and Ryan Douglas out on the ice now with Brendan Arell and Aiden McCarthy on defense.
Shots on goal 24-21 in Woodbridge's favor. Score 5-4 in Woodbridge's favor. That's the more important stat. Get it in there, underneath.
Got lost in the feet of a bunch of different players.
So for those of you from Manalapan who may be watching this live on Facebook or YouTube, or you might be watching this later on, pulling it off one of those venues or our website and our TV35 archives, we have nothing against Manalapan. Lovely city, go through there all the time, and I'm heading down to Freehold
there.
To my friend's house. We mean no harm or no animosity toward your team. We just want the Woodbridge team to win. Boy, I needed that break outside for a few minutes.
It's so cold in this rink.
I don't know why. This is colder than normal.
And it's, like, pretty warm outside, so.
Yeah. Well, that makes it feel worse.
Manalapan player pulls up.
Wide,
shot
right.
Misses wide. Brendan Arell picks up the puck, and it's behind his own net right now. Passes it over to Aiden McCarthy. Brendan with the puck again. There's a Manalapan player on him, though.
Wow, good move there,
yeah.
By
gets away
Arell.
From able to shake him off. No penalty there. Ryan Douglas gets the puck out. Pat Rennie's pressuring. Manalapan has it behind their own net. Passes it up to their blue line. Cross ice pass to Daniel Yacoub. Shot, good save by Hunter. Rebound, great block by Ryan Zwiebel.
Oh, he fanned on it.
Whiffed.
Here we go, here we go. Luco, catch up, man, catch up. There's Hubert.
Oh, icing. It looked like he got there, though.
Under 12 minutes now in the third period.
Faceoff's going to be in Woodbridge's zone. Dylan Godsell picks up the puck, passes over to Luco, gets caught in the Manalapan defender's skate. Huber dumps it all the way down into the Manalapan zone. Goalie stops it behind the net. Dumps it up the boards. Manalapan takes it through center ice. Nice little toe drag there, but good save by Hunter. Another face-off in the Woodbridge zone. Puck leaves the zone. Dylan Godsell's pressuring. Manalapan dumps it all the way back into the zone. Aiden McCarthy's there to pick it up for Woodbridge. Tries chipping it against the boards, but a Manalapan player gets there. Aiden McCarthy again, battling with the Manalapan player. Out to Luco, then to Dylan, back to Luco.
Wow, look at that pass.
To Hubert.
3-on-4. Got it.
Great cross-ice pass to Dylan. Good save by the goalie there. One again by Hubert. Dylan picks it up, sends it around the net. Manalapan dumps it all the way around the boards. No icing here. Brendan passes it to Aiden, to Dylan. Great pass there. Luco has the puck.
Hubert's open. Around. Hubert's there.
Huber with the puck. Loses it to a Manalapan defenseman. Luco with the puck now. Gets around a player. get stopped then. Luco's still pressuring the puck. All the way back to Wally at center ice. Passes it to Dylan. Oh, Dylan gets it taken from behind. No penalty there, which is a little weird. Good defense there by Pat. Braden takes it into the Manalapan zone. He has it. Good shot.
Oh.
No one's there for the rebound, though.
Under 10 minutes to go now. One third of the final period over.
Rayabolski picks it up in the corner, sends it to the slot, but it gets intercepted. Oh, good save by the Manalapan.
Oh, it could have been a sneaky one there.
Yeah. It's those shots you don't expect. Face-off in the Manalapan zone. Good face-off win there by Braden Rafferty. Right back to him. Shot. Oh, hits the Manalapan goalie in the head.
Uh-oh. Wow, that was dangerous. Get it over. That's it.
Pat takes the puck up into the Manalapan zone. Good defense by number two on Manalapan there. Sends it back down into the Woodbridge zone.
By the way, for those of you who are not as familiar with the players as Abby Karras is, that's Patrick Rennie.
Oh, yes, sorry.
That's okay. You're cool about that.
To Wally behind the net. Throws it up the boards. And all the way back down into the Woodbridge zone. Not sure what the ref's calling here. I think it's offside, I'm assuming. But it was a delayed offside, and they got back on. Wally with the puck here. Deep in the Manalapan zone. Manalapan sends the puck up around the boards. Center ice now. Rayabolski picks it up in the corner for Woodbridge. Oh, good cross ice pass by Manalapan.
Tie game.
Goal, number eight on Manalapan, Mike Schmelzer.
That was a tough one. It went off his shoulder, up in the air, and back behind him.
Not sure where the Woodbridge defense was on that one.
And now the hockey game begins, 5-5, 8:16 to go. Who's your NHL team?
I like the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I've seen them play when I visited my daughter out in Pittsburgh.
Oh, really? I went to see them play the Stanley Cup series against Nashville, the first game.
Really?
Yeah, because we were out there for, I don't even know what we were out there for, but I think maybe a graduation party for one of my cousins. Dylan Gotzel has it in the Manalapan zone, passes it over to Luco. Goes out to Aiden McCarthy. Luco has it in the corner, passes it back out to Aiden McCarthy. Good shot on
net. What a shot. What a hard shot.
Yeah. If there was someone there, they would have been able to get the rebound. Good D there by Aiden to stop the forward progress. Good save by Hunter. Oh. Big hit in center ice by Luco. Luco has it now. Shot gets blocked.
There's no overtime in high school hockey, right?
No. Unless it's playoffs or like one of those kinds of games.
Because I guess the ice is so scheduled, you know.
Yeah.
You can't afford to just give up 10 more minutes or anything like that because it'll push the whole rest of the day back.
Yeah, exactly. Good D there, making sure Manalapan doesn't get the puck.
Third period more than half over now.
Ooh, that might be a penalty.
I don't see anybody. No, it is. Yeah. Right. Goalie's coming off.
Got to make sure we touch this puck here. It's going to be a penalty on Huber Postlepeck. I think it's going to be either a boarding or a cross check. Only 6:53 left, so it'll be interesting to see what happens.
You don't have to hear from us, folks, to know how big this is on the penalty kill. 6:53 to go, game tied.
I think it's Manalapan taking a timeout here. they've been successful on the power play before, so Woodbridge has to talk about how they're going to keep them from scoring.
So, you know, what you said before might be true. 32 is dressed as a goalie, but he's not listed on the roster.
Oh.
So I think that's kind of odd.
Very odd.
So maybe he is the starting goalie and maybe 33 is the backup.
I don't know. It's so strange. I'm surprised he's not on this roster.
Yeah, me too.
But also, it's weird that a lot of these players haven't played 16 games.
Oh, there's a whole lot of names in this roster.
Yeah.
I wonder if they have a JV program, maybe.
Yeah, but still, even with that, it's... Oh, I mean, I guess they play both JV and varsity, and that's why they have that many games.
Well, no, they wouldn't mix up the stats.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just because you can't have... Because I'm seeing about five players here playing about 16 games, but there's, like, it should be more players playing all the games, if that makes sense.
True.
So maybe... But GP is always games played, so I don't know what else that could be.
No, that is. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 players that have played all 16 games. You're right. I would think there'd be more than that.
Yeah, it's strange.
Now we got to kill this.
Manalapan is working the puck within the Woodbridge zone. The strategy here is honestly just try to keep them outside and waste as much time as possible. Manalapan has it. Over to number 17. Good save by Hunter. Oh, no.
No.
It's gonna be a goal.
They moved already. No.
Goal for Manalapan.
The puck already moved, no?
Not sure.
I mean, the net already moved.
Yeah.
No, they got the goal. Let's go to the videotape. We have it. That all happened so quick. I couldn't tell if the net came loose before the goal or not.
Yeah.
If you're watching at home, well, you can't do replay at home.
Honestly, though, if the ref's unsure, he can't call that a goal. Bottom line, though, Woodbridge has to stop taking penalties. It's now 6-5 Manalapan with just over 6 minutes left. Oh, now ref's in the way. Luco comes down the ice. Oh, misses the net wide.
Figure like 5:30. Is that good? All right, great. Thanks.
Puck all the way down into the Woodbridge zone. It's going to be an icing.
Hey, can you do 5:45 with me here and Dr. Bueller?
Faceoff going to be deep in the Manalapan zone.
Sorry about that. I've had to take care of an appointment tonight.
No, you're good.
I would love to see that on video replay, see what happened.
Yeah.
But we still have time.
Shot block by Manalapan there. No ice. Brendan picks it up. Pass it over to Hubert. Good turn there to get the defender off of him. Pass it up to Luco.
Oh!
Almost an own goal there. Bounces right over Luco's stick behind the net. Good hit by Hubert over there. Good back check too.
Nice.
Luco with the puck. Shot on net. No rebound. Oh. Getting a little chippy here.
Well, we're down to goal. We can't do anything stupid.
Especially with the states on the line. This game really does nothing for...
Don't if you get thrown out of the game, don't you sit out the next game?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, states and county.
Yeah. How is that a... Oh, I think they're giving penalties.
Yeah, maybe offsetting.
Yeah, they cancel out. They should. But that still hurts since you're losing Hubert for 2 minutes or however long.
Well, there's nobody off the ice.
Yeah. Good shot there by Ryan Zweibel.
Get it in.
Goal!
Yeah!
It's all tied up at 6-6. They're back in it. Just under 5 minutes left.
Wow, what a game.
Definitely one of the closer ones for Woodbridge.
Well, when you only lose one and tie one, lose none and tie one.
Yeah, anything's going to be close.
I mean, I'm sure they'll love to escape here with a tie, but that's not the goal right now. Oh, watch out.
Oh, gosh.
That was dangerous.
Big hit on Ray Obolski. Puck comes right out to the center. Let's go. Goal by Ray Obolski. Rebound comes right out to center ice. 4:37 left in the period. Woodbridge is up 7-6.
Wow. This is one of the most exciting hockey games I've ever seen or called or anything.
That was like two goals in the matter
in seconds.
Yeah, 10, 15 seconds.
All right, now calm down, play defense.
Regroup, yeah.
And score another goal while you're at it.
Defense first, though, for sure. Manalapan dumps it into the Woodbridge zone.
All eyes are on the clock now, watching that countdown.
Brendan has the puck. Gosh. Ray Obolski picks it up, gets it out of the zone. Braden Rafferty, that's a hook.
That's a hook.
These refs, calling very much for Woodbridge here.
Why did they not call the hook?
That was pretty blatant, I thought. Luke has to get on sides here. There we go. Now Aiden can go in. Even the slash there. Right out to the center ice.
Under 4 minutes to go now, folks.
Good play by Dougie there, just keeping it in the zone. Defense has to be careful. Don't pinch too much. Great defensive play there by Dougie. Just get it deep in the zone. Manalapan flicks it out to the center of the ice. And all the way down into the Woodbridge zone. No ice, though. Brendan's there to pick it up.
Under 3.5 now. Hang on to it.
Brendan has it. Gets it. Oh, good defense there by the Manalapan defender.
That was very good defense.
I think that's Daniel Yacoub. He used to play hockey with him, actually. Onside. Great move by Luco. Oh, couldn't get the shot off, though. Big hit. That should have been a penalty after that hit, though, too. Good stick there by Brendan. Just get it deep.
Is it Brayden or Brendan?
Brendan, I believe. Brendan Arrow, but then Braden Rafferty.
Oh, my bad. Right, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, you're good. Wally has the puck now. Sends it over to Aiden.
To go.
Gets caught
in his
skates.
Don't lose it. Hit the ref.
There we go. Luco has the puck. Passes out to the center to Dylan.
Get it! Oh!
Great save by the Manalapan goalie.
That really was a good save.
Big hit in the corner, I think. Sweeps has the puck now.
Hit the ref
again. This ref. Offsides. Gotta get this puck out of the zone. Oh. Braden Rafferty has the puck, sends it up the boards. Ryan Douglas is there. All the way back into the Manalapan zone, just under 2 minutes left. Sends
it
to center ice. Way to get it deep there.
under 2 minutes.
Pap throws it to the middle.
Oh.
Ray almost gets a stick on it.
Yeah, almost. It's right.
Ray behind the net.
Just keep the pressure down air. Keep
passes
it down
it
air.
Passes it out to the point. Wally's going to have to get rid of this puck.
Uh-oh.
Oh, great stick there by Sweeps. All the way down into the Woodbridge zone. Wally has it.
A minute and a half to go.
To Pat.
Uh-oh.
Center ice. Way to get it deep there again.
Got to keep an eye on their goalie, see if they pull him with under a minute to go.
Just get it deep. There we go. No icing, too, because it's on net. Great play there.
1 minute to go. Uh-oh.
It's all right. We've got it.
Control it.
Flips it out to the center to Pat. Plays it to Ray. Oh, gets blocked by the Manalapan defender.
Don't give him this.
Number 8 comes down. Gets around Brendan,
nice.
But good D there again.
All right. That's huge.
We have our first line out again. Luca picks it up. Oh, Braden sends it to the boards.
Under 30.
Goal!
Yeah! Ryan Luca! Wow!
That should do it, hopefully.
Oh, yeah.
You never know with how this game's going, though.
You're right, but I'll take this one.
25 seconds
left.
Oh,
my God, I'm getting goosebumps with this game here. Oh, there's no reason to do that. Come on, guys. What a game. 4-0, 4-4, 5-4, 5-5, 6-5, 6-6, 7-6, 8-6.
This is wild.
Boy, this came at a good time for Woodbridge heading into the county and state tournaments.
Yes.
To beat a quality team like Manalapan.
Good D there by Brendan. Five seconds left in the game.
What a nice effort by the Woodbridge Triop. An unusual game for them in that they weren't ahead by a lot. They didn't mercy the other team. They just had a hard-fought, come-from-behind victory. And when I say come from behind, it was 4-0, folks.
Great game by Hunter Galgani, though.
Hunter played amazingly.
They're the reason why Woodbridge won this game, for sure.
And the goals, I didn't write the goals down, but they were spread out.
Oh, yeah.
We had a lot of different goal scorers.
Yeah. Great game by Manalapan, too.
Can we get any kids on? Is it possible to put them right down there? All right, let's go get the kids on, Abs.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, let's wrap it up, folks. We're going to go get some of the stars of the game. Woodbridge 8, Manalapan 6. Any last thoughts, Abby?
I think it was a great game. I mean, hard fought by both teams, so.
All right, let's get Hunter and maybe get some of the goal scores. We'll be back, folks.
Sounds good.
Okay, we're here now with the victorious Woodbridge Township hockey team. To my right, Patrick Rennie, Ryan Luco, Hubert Polchlopik, Ray Obolsky, Brendan Arrell, and the goalie, Hunter Galgani, and of course, the very first time on TV, she's been behind the microphone, Abby Karras. Abby, take it away.
So how did you guys feel down 4-0? What were your thoughts going into the second period?
I was just a little frustrated, flustered. And, you know, we just had to keep our cool and battle back.
What do you think there, Patrick?
We just kept our heads and we played hard.
What did the coach tell you after in between periods?
The coach actually didn't say a word. It was actually all the boys hyping us up.
Yeah.
And we were just like, we need to start playing for one another and play for Hunter.
So you're the captain. Did you feel did you have a role there saying, hey, guys, you know?
Yeah, I think I actually did my job today. Renberg can...
So Ryan, what do you know about Manalapan coming into the game? What did you think? They came in with two or three losses, so a good record.
I only knew that they had two pretty good players, and then the rest are solid. And then I just knew that we had to finish the job and stay undefeated.
Did you guys know? It seemed like the goalie wasn't the regular goalie because he wasn't even on the roster. Did you know anything about that?
I knew. So their one goalie got hurt, so they had to bring up a backup, so they brought up the JV goalie, and then they just played their regular goalie.
Oh, okay. All right, go ahead.
So after they tied it 6-6, what was going through your head?
Just keep playing the way we were playing. We fought back from four, so we could, when it's tied, we could always come back from that. We kept playing the way we played, and we came out with the W.
And how about your goal? What did you feel about your goal when you went kind of backdoored and kind of snuck in there? Was that yours?
Yeah, that was me.
What'd you think? Did you do that on purpose?
No, sure, that's right? A goal scorer's goal right there. No, I feel like it got the boys going a little bit, and that's when the momentum just started to kick.
It really did. It really kicked it out. So tell me what you got coming up now in the county tournament. Does everybody make the county tournament?
No.
How does that work?
It's the top four, so we're the one seed. Monroe's the second seed, Joe's is the third seed, and then Old Bridge is the fourth seed. So we have to play Old Bridge in the first round on Monday, and Joe's versus Monroe, and then the championship, whoever wins, is on Wednesday.
Okay, now you beat Old Bridge the first game at the club. What'd you do any time you played them?
No, we beat them like 7-2 and like 10-0.
Yeah, it was a sloppy performance by the Woody Boys.
All right. And tell me about the states.
We're in a good bracket. There's a lot of good teams, but I feel like we have a good shot to make it far.
And Hunter, how about you today? You look at the numbers, there was a heck of a lot of shots, but you were like playing out of your mind some of those saves.
Thank you.
Tell me more.
Just tried to keep my head when we were down. I let in two quick goals, and, you know, we just battled back. So.
All right, well, boys, congratulations, and good luck in the counties, and good luck in the states.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching, folks. So, Apps, this
Thank
is
you.
A fun, fun game to call
yes,
on TV, wasn't
very
it?
Very fun, yeah. It was exciting all three periods, so very excited to watch, very excited to call. So.
Well, you are a really good announcer.
Thank
it's only
you.
Your second game doing, right?
Yes.
You did phenomenal. You followed the puck, and it helps that you know the guys, you know their numbers. You did a terrific job, so congratulations.
Thank you so
much.
We'll
see what we can do next week between Monday and Wednesday in the counties. I don't know what our schedule is. I don't know what my schedule is, but I'd love to call these games.
Sounds good.
All right, thank you. Thanks for watching, folks.